والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. في بعض إن شاء الله سنن الوضوء. سنن الوضوء. First before we start, what the meaning of sunnah? The meaning of sunnah is the way, الطريقة. الطريقة or but also the word sunnah, as we said before, is the three things. Whatever the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he ordered us to do directly, and whatever the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he did it, and we just imitate the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, or whatever the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he saw someone doing something and we just like imitate him وسلم. Come to the Sunan Wudu, we spoke about Faraid Wudu, and what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mention in Surah Al-Ma'idah last week is that is Faraid Wudu. Then Sunan Wudu, we'll start with the first one is السواك. السواك and or السواك or المسواك, as the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لولا أشق على أمتي لأمرتهم بالسواك عند كل وضوء. Not in front of the people. This is really important, brothers. I'm not criticizing. A lot of people, they have in the siwak and just doing that in front of the people all the time. This is not the kind of the sunnah. The sunnah, there is a, you are speaking to the people, you completely put the siwak away, not brushing your teeth in front of the people. This is one of the etiquettes of the Muslim manners, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. So I'm not criticizing here. So again, the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he do want to make it hard to the Muslim ummah because not everyone can find a siwak. And one of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is a, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying another hadith, قال السواك مطهرة للفم مرضاة للرب. The siwak, using the miswak, it is matara, it is cleaning the mouth. Cleaning the mouth and the teeth. Cleaning the mouth and the teeth. And also, is mardat al-Rabb. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when using the miswak. And in fact, the angels will be around the person using the miswak. The angels will be around the person using the miswak. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he do it actually, most likely, he do it all the time, but most likely in five times صلى الله عليه وسلم. Number one, عند الوضوء. When you yeah, we put the water in the beard, inside the beard, and make sure the water reach the roots of the beard. Number six, تخليل أصابع اليدين والقدمين. You put the pinky or the small finger, just make sure between the fingers and also the toes. The water should be between the fingers and the toes. And with the small finger, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, عن المستورد بن شداد رضي الله عنه قال قال رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يخلل أصابع رجليه بخنصره. He saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم cleaning his toes toes, and he put his pinky finger in between the toes, between the toes. And it's very important. When the Prophet ﷺ last week, I said, Hadith, ضَيْلٌ لِلْعَقَابِ مِنَ النَّارِ, woe for those remain places in the feet, from the hot water that covered the feet completely, or otherwise the salah is not going to be valid. The salah itself is not to be valid. If the wudu, ablution is not completed, the salah is not valid. Number seven, التثليث. I think the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he came to the, and he took one Arabi from the Arabia, came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, teach me the wudu, ya Rasulullah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught him how to do the wudu. And then he made sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told him, yasaluhu, and he said, fa'arahu thalathan thalathan. Hadith on Sahih Bukhari. And then he showed him three times, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, in the end, فَمَنْ زَادَ عَلَى هَذَا فَقَدْ أَسَاءَ وَتَعَدَّى وَظَلَمْ. Whoever do more than three with not you think that means better than like four better than three or five better than three, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say that person asa'a is not doing wudu right wudu, wataadda that means transgress the line, wazalam he's unfair, because we are not better than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam need. But if there is necessary, something necessity, you see, you wash or your nose is not clean after three times, you want to do it four times, and your shoe is not clean, you can do it four times if there is necessary for that. And also tayammun. Tayammun start with the right side. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he yuhibbu tayammun fi kulli shay. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he liked to use his yameen, his right hand, his right leg, with everything sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, except entering the bathroom, even wearing his clothes with the right, even with the clothes with the right. Number nine, الدلك, rubbing the part. And what is الدلك? Is إمرار الماء ودلكه. مع الماء أو بعد الماء. Again, say to put the water and rubbing the hand or the body with the water. You put the water and you make it rubbing the body, or after put the water, you're rubbing the body. This both. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم حديث عبد الله بن زيد رضي الله تعالى عنه قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أتى بسلتمد فتوضأ فجعل يدلك ذراعيه. He said the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he had a pot of water and he started to make the wudu and he started to rubbing his arms صلى الله عليه وسلم. Number 10, الموالاة, the sequences. Number 10, the sequences, one after one. You cannot, you know, start with the mouth and then the face, then come to, back to the nose. It has to be sequences. Number 11, مسح الأذنين. You know, wiping with a head, and we say the head is obligation. And we agree last week that means the ears part of the head. Last week we agreed that the head is part of the ears part of the head, and we don't say the neck part of it. We don't say the neck is part of the head at all. The head is something and the neck is something else. So the sunnah to wipe your head, your hair, and your ears. And how you do this? Put the sababa, these two fingers in the ear, and the libham, the thumb in around the ears. Around the ears. Let's see, this way, and around the ears. Around the ears. And number 12, إطالة الغرة والتحجيل. And this is nice. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, when he is describing his friends, that means us. And the Sahaba asking the Prophet, how are you going to know those people that come after you, Ya Rasulullah? And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he gave the example of the very genuine good horse, white horse, among a lot of black horses. And those black horses is not really good, but that white one is good. That one is, and Muhajjal. Muhajjal is in his feet, and the top of the feet is a black circle around the feet. That was Muhajjal. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, how you know, you're going to know your friends, that means the Muslims come after you, after the Sahaba, after the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يأتوا غرلا محجلين من آثار الوضوء. Say they will come with, they have like trace of the wudu on them. May Allah make us among those people. Ameen. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, I will, what is the meaning here in the hadith? Say, He said, wash the arm all the way to the elbow. It's okay to make it in the tub. It's not a master or like a ruler or something to make it exactly to the elbow. It's okay to make it a little bit above the elbow or the head also in the same thing. And the feet. And the feet is not exactly to the ankle. In Abu Huraira, Hadith Abu Huraira in Bukhari, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, it is a little bit above the ankle. You know, he used to do it as sock. As sock, that means his. At the Sahih Bukhari, and he was washing his feet and all the way to his chin. Yeah. This is Sunan al Wudu. We'll go to number 13, and this is really important. And we have to speak khutbah Jum'ah about number 13. هي الاقتصاد في الماء. هو الاقتصاد عدم الإسراف في الماء عند الوضوء. Not wasting a lot of water when we making wudu, even if you are in the masjid or home, or even if you making wudu in the river or the ocean, do not waste. Just use what you need. And many hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يقتصد الصاع إلى خمسة أمداد. صاع is just like 400 centimeters, cubic centimeters. It's just like a pot, just like this. And he making wudu and ghusl صلى الله عليه وسلم. And it's not much. And number 14, and that is, we're going to speak about this more in detail, الدعاء بعد الوضوء. دعاء after wudu. Not through the wudu. Not, because some people, they wash their hands and there is دعاء. Mouth, there is دعاء. Nose, there is دعاء. Face, there is دعاء. There is absolutely bid'ah. Absolutely bid'ah. It's the دعاء only after the wudu. Hadith Sahih Muslim, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, من قال أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله فتحت له أبواب الجنة الثمانية فليدخل كيف شاء. Whoever say أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله, the eight gates of heaven will be open for that person. And رب صلى الله عليه وسلم let that person, if he die now, let him enter from any door, any gate he wants. May Allah make us among those people. Ameen. And of course you can add, Allahumma ja'alni min at-tawabin wa ja'alni min at-tahirin. But there's not authentic hadith regarding this, by the way. But this is dua. You can make any dua after that, it's fine. But the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sahih Muslim, he said all the way, أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهِ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا عَبْدُهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَاللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى أَعْلَمُ. You have this hadith there. نعم, إن شاء الله. Now, sisters and brothers, let's speak about نواقض الوضوء. نواقض الوضوء, what is nullifying your wudu. Of course, all of us, we know, ما خرج من السبيلين, من البول والغائط. Whatever comes from the sources like the urine, the sperm, the madi, any liquid come after urination or during the urination, any liquid comes from the both sides, that will be breaking the wudu. Simple. We're not going to go in details because we spoke about it once, inshallah. Number three or two, النوم العميق. Meaning deep sleeping. Deep sleeping, that breaking the wudu. Meaning if you are sitting like Brother Saeed, exactly, like Brother Saeed, and you sleep like this, even if you make sound, or whatever, that way, if you sit like this, you're sitting, and you completely, excuse me, your back exactly on the floor. Your back exactly on the floor, on the ground, and you sleep. And even if you make sound, your wudu is valid. Meaning if you, this is like your brother sitting and your feet up, it's okay, but your feet up and you sleep, it is not guaranteed that your wudu is there. So على هيئة المتمكن, you're sitting, and you are comfortable with the sitting, and you know exactly you're not releasing air. And there is many hadith. If you go back to the book, you'll find actually almost the whole page speaking about the proofs. In the Sahaba, they used to sleep and make sound, but they are sitting, and على هيئة المتمكن, they are comfortable with their sitting. And they used to wake them up and go straight and make them wudu. There's many hadith even in Sahih al-Bukhari. It's a problem. صلى الله عليه وسلم كان أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ينتظرون العشاء الآخرة من صلاة العشاء. المغرب also we call it العشاء because it's dark. Because العشاء حتى تخفق رؤوسهم نازلين they completely getting their heads down like sleeping. ثم يصلون ولا يتوضؤون. Then they pray without the wudu. And in the presence of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Number three, زوال العقل. Number three, زوال العقل. When the person completely become insane, that the person have to make wudu. It become like have his sanity after that. He start to distinguish what is right, what is wrong. That means he can make the wudu. He has to make wudu. Or faint. If the person faint, wake up, he has to make the wudu. Also, if the person become drunk, as a, oh, that means drunk is halal. We don't say it's halal, but some people, but still the person is not kafir. The person is not kafir. Also, they have to person wudu. Sometimes they take medication. Some medication and become unaware what's going on around. And wake up, the person have to make his wudu also. And regardless, if this is like, for a moment he can faint or long time, still he have to make the wudu, regardless. So, naam. Number four, and Bardo, after that we can have one chapter about the controversy between this kind of, sometimes, about, for example, number four. مس الفرج بدون حائل. If the person touching his private area without veil, for some, like pants or claws or something like this, that also breaking the wudu. حديث يسرى بنت صفوان رضي الله تعالى عنها أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من مس ذكره فلا يصلي حتى يتوضأ. حديث في البخاري أن مسلم قال she said the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said whoever touches a private area and that person have to make the wudu. But if you touch it unintentionally, you're taking shower and you're making wudu and you touch it unintentionally, والله أعلم that is fine. والله أعلم that is fine. المذاهب الثلاثة أحمد الشافعي عن مالك. أحمد الشافعي عن مالك he said مس الذكر مس touching the private area is not breaking is breaking the wudu except Abu Hanifa رحمه الله تعالى and he said that it doesn't break the wudu and he took the hadith رحمه الله تعالى. And when one man came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, يا رسول الله, ever touch the private area, يسمي ذكرى, هل علي وضوء? Does that person have وضوء? قال إنما هو بضعة منك. He is part of your body. The private area is part of your body. That means not breaking the وضوء. But that hadith is abrogated hadith. That hadith منسوخ. That's what is the meaning is that because we have ahadith كثيرة, a lot of ahadith received by Ahmad, by Shafi'i, by Malik. That means the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he ordered the Sahaba to make the wudu after that. come before we take it inshallah the discussion because we're gonna go through some area that is different opinion. Different opinion. What is and I can call it ما ينقض وضوء. What is the different opinion? For example, some people they have a problem with camel meat. They say camel meat is an option. And they take this excuse, and please, first, let me repeat read the hadith for you in Sahih Muslim. And Ahmed too. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, one man came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, يا رسول الله, أنا توضأ من لحوم الغنم. Should we make wudu when we goat or sheep? And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, لا, إن شئت توضأ وإن شئت فلا تتوضأ. So if you want to make wudu, make wudu. If you don't want to make wudu, don't make wudu. That means it is, you have the option. You have the option. And he is the same man. He said, قال يا رسول الله, أنا توضأ من لحوم الإبل. من لحوم الإبل. Should we make wudu when we eat camel meat? And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم قال نعم. And he repeats, قال نعم, توضأ من لحوم الإبل. He said, yes, make wudu from the camel meat. So someone will say, no, it is an option because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was sitting, and this is not true here. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was sitting among his Sahaba, and he smelled something, somebody like released air. And when we went for Salah, everybody went for Salah. No one make wudu. And then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, said, okay, whoever ate camel meat, and everybody ate camel meat, of course, make wudu. So this is not true, brothers and sisters. The ahadith regarding this is very clear and clean. With not even one single proof that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this happened. People try to justify that. It is not. Like some people pray with their hands down here. Down, not in the chest, not down. What is their justification is? Is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the end of his days, and he was old, and then he cannot put his hand up, he starts to put his hand down. This is not true too. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he got sick how many days? Five days only. And how many pray among those 5 days? Only 2 days, while he's sitting next to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he got sick 5 days. A few months before, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was fighting in Tabuk. So we're not talking about an old man, 63 years, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a very strong man. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he got sick 5 days. So he prayed the third day and the fifth day. He prayed the third day and the fifth day, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that's it. And he prayed while he's sitting next to Abu Bakr. So whoever say that put your hands because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam pray like this, it is not true. And he ordered us, he said, نَحْنُ مَعَاشِرَ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ We have the مَعَاشِرَ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ All the prophets, they have an order to put their hand, right hand over the, on the left hand, on the chest. They have an order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, eating camel meat, that is breaking the wudu. Touching the private area, and we have ahadith, many ahadith, also breaking the wudu. We have also, and this is important, touching your wife, because some people, if your wife touch you like this, he gets very angry because I have to make wudu again. Some wives, they're teasing their husbands to do so. And this is not true. The Prophet said, Hadith Aisha, and we're talking about the Hadith Aisha. When the Hadith, he says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قَبَّلَهَا, he said, he kissed me, وَهُوَ صَائِمْ. And when he fasting, and she said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ الْقُبْلَ لَا تَنْقُضُ الْوُضُوءِ وَلَا تُفْطِرْ الصَّائِمْ وَلَا تُفَطِّرْ الصَّائِمِ. The hadith is clear, my dear brothers and sisters. Al-Qubla, the kiss, kissing your wife, is not breaking the wudu and is not breaking the fast. And also, one of the modesty, haya of Aisha, radiallahu anha, she said once, إن الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يقبل إحدى زوجاته. إحدى زوجاته بعض نسائه ثم خرج إلى الصلاة. He used to kiss one of his wives. To mean herself, of course, by her haya, she didn't want to say he used to kiss me, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he go and pray, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, touching the woman, and many ahadith, I want everybody to go to the book, and she was sleeping, and mashallah, the room is very small, he making tahajjud, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and when he go to the sujood, she spread her feet in front of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would touch her, like pushing her feet away. So he's touching Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. Her feet, or the clothes in the top of the feet, Allahu alam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, alam. So, touching your wife, it is not breaking the wudu. Also, إذا شك المتوضئ في الحدث, you have a doubt. You have a wudu, or you don't have a wudu. If you don't know, that means you have a wudu. You are doubtful. You release air or not releasing air. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said clearly in the hadith, قال, لا ينصرف حتى يسمع صوتا أو يجد ريحا. The hadith is very clear. Say, do not leave your salah unless if you hear voice or sound releasing air or you smell something Then you leave the salah. Otherwise, don't make the shaitan whispering to you that you are having no wudu. And suppose you come into the masjid and I don't know I have wudu or you don't have wudu. You don't know. You're 100% you're doubtful. So brothers and sisters, you enter the masjid, you have wudu. At least if you are sure, you don't have wudu. فالأصل هو معك wudu. الأصل here, you have the wudu. Oh, I don't know if I release air or not. I still have wudu or not. ده الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said do not make the whispering if you are not sure that means you already have the wudu. We have many ahadith in your book regarding this inshallah. Number five, I think, خروج الدم. And we spoke about it last week. I said if the person have blood, blood, and we said the blood mean from wound. I say still you have, you can pray. Hadith in Bukhari, ما زال المسلمون يصلون في جراحاتهم. The Muslims, they, when they have been wound with the bloody and they are used to fight, they still they pray with the wudu. That means the wudu is not breaking the wudu. Now the question is, do we have different opinion regarding this? Yes, there is. There is different opinion. Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah ta'ala, Imam Shafi rahimahullah ta'ala, say your wudu is breaking. You break. And I'm not going to go in details with that, but Imam Malik and Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal say your wudu is not break. So you still have wudu. Vomiting, it is not breaking the wudu. Vomiting is not breaking the wudu. Regardless, you have a little vomiting or a lot of vomiting, we don't have in the Sunnah not even one single hadith. Not even one single hadith. That means the person have to have a wudu when the person vomits. Now, the last one is غسل الميت. لا يفسد الوضوء إلا إذا لمست بشره. Or washing the deceased, the dead person, is not breaking the wudu unless you touch the private area for the dead person. I'll stop here, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. We'll take questions and discussion if you have, inshallah. Wudu, can we do the head and then the ear after that separately? The sister or brother asking question, he said, can we beat the head one time and then the ears in one time? Yes, you can, but the sunnah to do it both together. The sunnah to be head and ears together. That is the sunnah. Wallahu subhanahu wa ta'ala a'lam. I have the other question on another website. There, let me know, inshallah. Brother is here, inshallah. Yes, brother Fida. When you turn in your fingers, you do like this, either like this or like this. Afghani way like this. Arab. Yes, inshallah. Yes, Abu Karim. Yes, there is different opinion that I go through that much actually. Madhab. Which madhab? Salafi madhab, right? All right. I spoke about the madhab before, brothers and sisters. It's no harm to follow a certain madhab. No harm to follow a certain madhab. This is number one. Number two, we have to put in consideration our four imams, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi, Ahmad ibn Hanbal, they are here in the top of our heads. And no one have any comment, should not say any comment about the four imams. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them rahmah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them for everything they have done to give us from their knowledge. Ameen. If you don't have time to searching for knowledge, I said yes, follow a certain madhab. You don't have time. But in the same time, if you have a hadith come to you, like for example, about the camel meat. The camel meat. So Imam Shafi said, no, it is an option. You want to do it, do it. You don't want to do it, don't do it. But I have authentic hadith in Muslim and Ahmed. That means we must make wudu when we eat the camel meat. And you will receive this. Don't say, oh, هذا ما وجدنا عليه آباؤنا. وَإِنَّ عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ مُقْتَدُونَ أَوْ مَهْتَدُونَ الْآيَةِ الْأُخْرَىٰ. Don't say that what we found our parents and that we have to follow their footsteps. No. When we have a hadith or ayah, what we have to say? سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. But yes, you can follow a certain school of thought if you don't have time to search more from us. فضل إن شاء الله. Yes. I like that statement. I like, say, according to here, that means I'm following the four madahib. That's what we're supposed to do, be honest with you. Yeah, what we're supposed to do for four madahib. Because these four imams, the greatest imams ever. The greatest imam, those four imams. May Allah give him rahmah. Ameen. So, what I say to the brothers and sisters, If you follow four of them, mashallah, it's very good. I pick up from one here, one here, one here, one here, it's fine too. Isn't that the problem line? Okay. if a person pass, okay guys, for or air, is he supposed to redo the wudu? Of course. If the person for sure pass air, that person have to change his wudu. Can Soya, can you show that? Show that what? Oh. Okay. Yes, I do like this. And put these two fingers here, and this two, my thumb, this way. I don't know if you can see that in the camera. Like this. Okay, you can see that? Okay. So one finger, this one here, and this one, the ibham, the thumb, in the top of it. Yes, yes. The sister asking how you wipe the head. Do you do like this and like this? You know, you do one up and down. So what about you, sister? You know, maybe you have a long hair. Okay, you don't have to do all, you have a long hair. You don't have to wipe over, just in your head, part of the head, as we said. As we said last week. Part of the hair, of the head, or the whole head. It's up to you, inshallah. Wallahu alam. Yes, sister. Oh, wiping the socks. I said next week I will have a special. But yes, the answer is yes. Wiping over your socks, and regardless, if, as far as you cannot see your skin from your socks, meaning with the skin, that means thin socks. Thin socks. What did the woman wear? What's called it? Pantyhose. Pantyhose. Sorry. Yeah. That one is not accepted. That one is not accepted because you can see through it your skin very well. But if you're wearing a socks like what you're wearing, sister, here, that is fine 100%. Yeah, even have it not like a white, we have this white socks and sometimes we have thin, but it's not very thin. You cannot see the skin through it. That is fine, and I have all the proofs regarding this, inshallah, next week. Bi-idhnillah, Rabbi Ami, yes, sisters. That's fine. Yes, let me just repeat your question for the sisters and the brothers online. The sister asking if the person sitting, and we say sitting like crossing their legs like this, if you see that in camera, and then sitting completely, how long the time of the sleeping? Regardless, the Sahaba, we used to sit from Maghrib all the way to the Isha. From Maghrib to the Isha, so Allahu A'lam, how long is that? How long is that? But don't push it. You know, the person, you really want to go to the bathroom. Call it مدافعة الأخبثين. Do you really want to go to the bathroom? No, go to the bathroom. Because you're going to lose your خشوع completely. You're going to lose your humility. خشوع is completely. And as I mentioned before, I say, الخشوع هو روح الصلاة. الخشوع, the humility, is the spirit of the salah. So we really should really concentrate on the salah, not concentrate going to the bathroom or not. Abu Khalid, inshallah. It's a good question. It's a valid question. It happened. Not with me. The brother asked a question. He said, if you are the imam and people behind you, hundreds of people behind you, and suddenly you remember you don't have wudu, or you lost your wudu. It's in reality, it happened to Umar ibn Khattab, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. It happened to Umar ibn Khattab. And Umar ibn Khattab, he told the people, hala masafikum. That means stay there. Stay there, hala masafikum, stay there. and he went to make wudu and he came back. He went and Umar and Ali رضي الله تعالى عنه. And look at this, the adab of the Sahaba. Look at the adab of the Sahaba. قال علي يا 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 أمير المؤمنين قد فضحت نفسك أمام الخلق. What is فضحت here? Not slandering. Expose yourself. Expose yourself front of خلايا, front of the people. قال يا علي فضوح الدنيا ولا فضوح الآخرة. الله أكبر. قال يا علي to be exposed in the dunya better than to be exposed in the akhirah. So he told the people, and it happened to me when I was 15 years old, by the way, when I was in khutbah al-jum'ah. So jazakumullah khair. The answer is you either have one of the two choices. One of the two choices. You are a regular imam. You can tell the people, stay, I lost my wudu, and you go and make wudu and come back. But in this century, the people will kill you. But what you do the other way, jazakumullah khairan, I say, whoever behind you, that's why the sunnah, always behind the imam, should be ulil al-amri wa nuha. What do they know? The people, they know the Quran, they are the people of the shura, adults, mature, people who know about the sunnah, always should be behind the imam. That is the sunnah, inshallah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, قَالَّ يَلِلِّي مِنْكُمْ أُولِي الْأَمْرِ وَالنُّهَى. Should be following behind me the people of the maturity. Mature. And you can drag, bring someone and tell him, finish the salah on behalf of me. Finish the salah. And now you have another two choices now. Either when you make wudu, come and join the salah, or you can go back and you take over. The question is, hey, Brother Ibrahim, I lost two rak'ah already. Come from scratch, from the beginning, or continue? Inshallah, chapter of the salah will speak about this in detail. Yes, he did continue. What, Brother Abu Khalid? He wants the answer now. Yes, Umar, continue. In fact, yes, Akhamjad. Yeah, that you have to start from scratch. Yeah, we're going to speak about this in detail, which is the chapter of the Salah, Abu Tariq. Tired. فتاوى كل فتاوى على الهواء. اوكي يو رايت.